الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله من العلي من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear sweet brothers, dear sisters, alhamdulillah. We just finished Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah. May Allah Azza wa Jal make it an hour hasanat awl. Amin ya Arhamar Rahimin. Let's talk today, inshallah, about something all of us would like to talk about it, about Jannah and these Sahaba and that some of the Tabi'een also, they get glad tidings of paradise in Jannah and how they earn it. This is very important. And how can we do it too? How can we earn it too? First of all, what is the meaning of the glad tidings of Jannah and what does it mean? Companions who earned the honor collectively and the companions who earned this honor also in groups. Companions who earned this honor individually also and how they lived after being given glad tidings of Jannah. Two important points to ponder upon. Also, how can we to earn the glad tidings of Jannah like them? Some righteous deeds that qualify for glad tidings of Jannah. Very important, dear brothers, to understand this meaning. And this is a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give glad tidings through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to somebody or someone who was walking on this earth, still alive. Imagine that. Subhanallah, if you get that message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you're going to be one of the Jannah. While you're still alive, you did not die yet. Subhanallah, it's a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, collectively in groups also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in general, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ, this is in general, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. This is not just only for the Sahaba. This could be for you too. Yes. فالله سبحانه وتعالى said whosoever obeys Allah and his messenger. To obey Allah means the Quran al-Kareem. And to obey the messenger of Rasulullah means his examples and his sunnah. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Because nowadays we have too many different sects. I can say they've been misguided and they try to take people in their ways. Sunnah, radifat al-Quran, like we said that, but Sunnah, you can judge al-Quran by Sunnah too, because Sunnah explained that treasure, which is the Holy Quran, to many things. Allah did not mention it in the Holy Quran. It is in the Sunnah. For that's why Allah said, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَالرَّسُولُ, whoever obeys Allah and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. There will be among those who has blessed, they are the messengers, the truthful, Siddiqeen like Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the witnesses or the martyrs, and the righteous Salihin, may Allah make us all amongst them. What excellent companions these are. This Surah An-Nisa, verse 69. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if the condition here, I am not a Nabi, I'm not a Siddiq, I may be Salih or not, Allah A'lam. Subhanallah, I am not a messenger, but we have two conditions here. If you obey Allah and the Rasul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will admit you with these Anbiya and the Salihin and the Shuhada, subhanahu wa Siddiqeen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned also the companions who earned this honor collectively, the early companions of Al Muhajirin or Al Ansar. And they was talking about yesterday, Al Muhajirin or Al Ansar. And I was talking about that ayah in Surah Al-Anfal. I am about to finish, inshallah, today, the last ayat, three ayat in Surah Al-Anfal, inshallah, in my tafsir. The meaning of al-muhajirin, people, they said somebody's gone to Hawaii. They were not going to Hawaii. These people, they left their properties, families, kids. They left everything and they migrated twice to Abyssinia. Then they followed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam too. Al-Madina, and they were less than 300 people. And the Battle of Badr is telling us that, right? So that's why these Muhajirin, who lifted everything جاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم. They strove for the sake of Allah, in the way of Allah, with their money. They lifted in Mecca already. He lifted for the sake of Allah. And they followed Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم empty hand, has nothing. عبد الرحمن بن عوف, he was so rich. When he went to Medina, nothing in his hand. And the Rasul made dua for him. And subhanAllah, he became one of the richest. See? For they lifted everything, their wives, their family, their kids, their money. That's why they strove with their money. And then وأنفسهم in the battle of Badr, first battle in Islam. في سبيل الله. SubhanAllah, that's why المهاجرين, they had very high status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only المهاجرين وتبوت الأنصار والذين آووا ونصروا. Those who give the asylum and they help. الأنصار, المدينة. I told you yesterday, the one from الأنصار, صحابي, he used to tell the one from المهاجرين, he's coming to him. He's a host and this is a guest. He's telling him, four wives, I have these five gardens or whatever. You choose whatever you want from them. Oof, you can choose my money, you can choose my house, my garden, but even my wives. يعني في العرب, عند العرب something big, يعني somehow it's my wife. Maybe I love her. And this is up to your choice. Who can do that? This is al-Iman. Nobody can get this level. That's why المهاجرون الأنصار, they were and they are the foremost. Allah said, سبحانه وتعالى, والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرون الأنصار. And سورة الواقع said, والسابقون السابقون, the foremost. The المهاجرين والأنصار. سبحان الله. These people, they will enter الجنة with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. First group will enter الجنة with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Also, those who participate, the participants of Badr and Al-Hudaybiyah, those who participated in the Battle of Badr and Al-Hudaybiyah, these people, subhanallah, Rasulullah said in the hadith, لن يدخل الجنة النار, لن يدخل النار رجل شهد بدرا والحديبية. Any man, he attended the Battle of Badr and Al-Hudaybiyah, at the treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah and Al-Hudaybiyah, he will never enter hellfire. Oof. It's a glad tidings for them all. Now, groups now, not just individually, one by one. People, they think, most of them, the only people get glad tidings of Jannah, those who've been mentioned one hadith collectively. Like this 10, I'm going to mention them to you right now. No. Before like 3 Ramadans, I was talking about them in details between Maghrib and Isha here, between Tarawih. It is in my YouTube channel. I mentioned more than 35 Sahabi and Tabi'i, and those even who came before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the wife, like the maid of the daughter of Fir'aun. Subhanallah, she was before the time of Fir'aun. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave her glad tidings of Jannah. She's in Jannah, see? For there are too many, not just the 10 in one hadith, okay? For also the companions who earned this honor in groups, the family of Yasir in the streets of Mecca, Ammar, Sumayya, subhanallah, Ammar ibn Yasir, Yasir and Sumayya, his mom, first martyrs in Islam, Sumayya. Subhanallah, Rasulullah was passing by them while they've been tortured in the streets of Mecca, and they said, Isbiru ala Yasir, Isbiru or Sabran ala Yasir, fa inna maw'idakum al-jannah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. Patience, O family of Yasir, your meeting place will be paradise. This glad tidings, right? Subhanallah. And Sayyidina Ammar ibn Yasir, he died when he was 50 years. He'd been killed also after he became 50 years. But he'd been tortured with his dad and his mom. And the subhanAllah, when he fainted, they asked him to say something bad about Rasulullah ﷺ, and he did say it. And Allah gave ayah because of that incident. He said, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَا وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِمَانِ وَلَكِنْ مَنْ شَرَحَ بِالْكُفْرِ صَدْرًا فَعَلَيْهِمْ غَضَبٌ. SubhanAllah. فعمر بن ياسر said the word of kufr after he was about to faint. He saw his mom and his father, they've been killed as a shaheed, martyrs, both of them, in front of him. And Allah said, no problem. كيف تجدك يا عمار? Rasul asked him, how was your heart? He said, I love you, Rasulullah. I'm sorry. He said, don't worry. إلا من أكره. You've been forced for that. وإن عادوا فعود. If they ask you again, don't say whatever you want. Don't worry about it. If your heart with me, that's it. Don't worry about it. You know, we take this. Also, the 10 in the famous hadith, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned them also. Abu Bakr fil Jannah. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq in paradise. Radiallahu anhu arda. Wa Umar fil Jannah. Umar in paradise. Wa Uthman fil Jannah. Uthman in paradise. Wa Ali fil Jannah. Ali, radiallahu anhu, in paradise. Wa Talha fil Jannah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, great sahabi, in paradise. Wa Zubayr, Hawari Rasulillah, in paradise. Zubayr ibn Awam. وعبد الرحمن بن عوف في الجنة in paradise. سعد في الجنة, سعد بن أبو قاص the uncle of رسول الله in paradise. وسعيد ابن زيد في الجنة in paradise. وأبو عبيدة ابن الجراح في الجنة the trustworthy of this أمة, أمين هذه الأمة in جنة. These are collectively 10 in one hadith. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said they are going to Jannah while they were walking still in Medina. سبحان الله. Imagine that they get the, what did they do? These people, they sacrifice their life, their money first, because Allah, when Allah talk about the jihad or mujahada, he talk about money first. He mentioned money before the nafs, because people, they are mal wal banun, people that love money so much. سبحان الله. الحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم also they get glad tidings of Jannah. الحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة, like what رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, are the sheaves of the youth of paradise. سبحان الله. And this message for the شباب too. Companions who earned this honor individually. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he mentioned them. First, our mother, may Allah be pleased with her, we love her so much, and she been oppressed in our Islamic history. خديجة بنت خويلد رضي الله عنها. They talk about أم سلمة, they talk about عائشة, طبعا they are our mothers, all of them. But خديجة, they did not give her her rights. والله خديجة جماعة, she was the first seed in Islam with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. She sacrificed her time, her life, her money before that for رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. She never betrayed him. She never make it hard for him. She used to love him. That's why رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when خديجة the noble lady, Rasulullah was working for her. When he get married with her, he said, Ya Rasulullah, هذه خديجة. Who said that? جبريل عليه السلام. Ya Rasulullah, this is خديجة. She's coming to you. And she's carrying إناء فيه إدام أو طعام أو شراب. سيدنا جبريل telling Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, this is خديجة coming to you with a dish, having meat, soup, or some food or drink. When she reached you, greet her on behalf of Allah. Allah salam, saying salam to Khadija. And on my behalf too, Jibreel, saying salam to Khadija. And give her glad tidings of what? Palace, a palace in paradise, made from pearls, wherein there will be neither noise nor fatigue. I said that yesterday, Hadith. I explained it to you already. And why she, there is no fatigue, she would never be tired, no fatigue anymore. And she was serving, noble lady, and she was above 60 during that time, 63 maybe. Subhanallah. She was serving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She never gonna be tired anymore. And no noise in her house in Jannah, in her palace. Why? Because she kept her house clean and quiet for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She never shout to him, she never say anything like our sisters nowadays. May Allah guide them, ya Rabbil Alameen. Suhaib ibn Sinan, Suhaib al-Rumi also. Suhaib al-Rumi, he left, he was so rich, he came poor to Mecca, and he became so rich, and he sacrificed, and he left all of his property, money, whatever, and he followed Rasulullah. And Rasulullah, when he saw him, after he was fighting the kuffar, subhanallah, he said, Rabih al-Bay' Aba Yahya, Rasulullah saw him coming from far away distance. He told, Rabih al-Bay' Aba Yahya, Rabih al-Bay' Aba Yahya, and Allah mentioned Quran also, regarding this incident, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu, Rasulullah said, the deal has profited, O Aba Yahya, the deal has profited, O Aba Yahya, the deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He left everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bilal ibn Rabah, the muazzin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani imagine that, subhanallah, Bilal from Abyssinia, Suhaib al-Rumi, Byzantine, yani he's not from Mecca or Medina. And subhanallah, Rasulullah said, give them glad tidings, sahawat, yani Islam, we are all under the same umbrella. We are all Muslim. That's it. Don't look at the color, the tongue, or whatever. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was telling Bilal ibn Rabah after Salat al-Fajr, Ya Bilal, tell me, bi-arja amali amaltahu fi al-Islam. What is the best good deed you're doing, man, in Islam? Tell me, ya Bilal. He said, why Rasulullah is asking me that? He said, because I heard your footsteps in Jannah, ya Bilal. What are you doing? He said, qala ma amiltu amalan arja indi. أني لم أتطهر طهورا في ساعة ليل أو نهار إلا صليت بذلك الطهور ما كتب لي أن أصلي. said I'm not doing something يعني extremely يعني يا رسول الله يعني too much. He said I'm just I keep myself in the condition of purification all the day. Whenever I make wudu, I pray whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me capability to pray. I pray, يعني, according to my subhanahu until I get tired. I pray. He said, that's it. That's why I heard your footsteps in Jannah, ya Bilal. Glad tidings. Subhanallah. And why I mention all of these a'mal? Because to follow these sahaba, to make like them, how to approach in Jannah? Make like Bilal. Make like the sahaba, sacrifice. Do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, hafiz al-Quran. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud also was a slave. See, Rasulullah ibn Mas'ud about the slaves. They were slaves. But Islam honored them. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, when he was trying to get some siwak or something, sahaba, they saw his legs. Very skinny. He was a Yemeni guy. And Yemeni people, most of them, they are small, tiny people. And they said, subhanAllah, but they are great. Sahaba, most of them from Yemen, to be honest with you. So Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Tufail ibn Amr al-Dusi, too many. They were from Yemen. And subhanAllah, and they still, subhanAllah, until now, they have very good voice in the Quran when they make nasheed or Quran, Yemeni people, subhanAllah. Not from the Qat, because the Qat is haram for me. Allah gave them. Yes. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, when the Sahaba, they were making fun of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud because his legs were skinny. He said, La rajlu, Abdullah, athqal fil mizan yawm al-qiyamah min Uhud. Allahu Akbar. He said, the leg, why you're making fun of him? The leg of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud will be heavier in the balance on the day of resurrection than Mount Uhud. Allahu Akbar. Why? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, ya jama'a, if you study his biography, he said, I know 70 surah of the Quran. 70 means the whole entire Quran. 70, if you count from Al-Baqarah, to 70 means that's, يعني, lift by like 37 in Juz Amma, or the rest, يعني, the short surah. Means the whole entire Quran. He said, I know why Allah sent it, and when Allah sent it, and for what Allah sent it, the reason why Allah sent it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يعني, من سره أن يعني أن يستمع إلى القرآن غضا طريا فليستمع إلى قراءة ابن أم عبد. If you want to listen to the Quran with a beautiful voice, sweet voice, listen to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him permission to enter his house without permission. يعني he can go to Rasulullah anytime without knocking the door. Yes. Like what he say, سلمان منا آل البيت, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud too. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was spoiling him. He used to love him so much. Subhanallah. Because they did for Islam. And they said, بل هو من أهل الجنة. بل هو من أهل الجنة. ثابت بن قيس also, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he is from أهل الجنة. سعد بن معاذ, وما أدراك ما سعد بن معاذ. سعد بن معاذ, يا جماعة, he was in Islam more less than 6 years, 6-7 years. He died when he was 38. And he was the leader of الأوس. سعد بن معاذ, since he entered to Islam, half of المدينة, الأوس, he was the leader of الأوس, they entered Islam. Imagine that, half of the city. Of المدينة, they entered the Islam, the city of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. When he died as a shaheed, سعد بن معاذ, يعني سبحان الله, when I say 6-7 years in Islam and he did all of this, and the 70,000 angels, they follow his funeral, سعد بن معاذ, and the throne of Allah was shaking to his death. Why? Because عرش الرحمن missed him, loves him. عرش of Allah loved, the dominion of Allah loves سعد بن معاذ. Subhan, that's why he was shaking out of happiness. Yes, اهتز له عرش الرحمن. 70,000 angels, they follow his funeral. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was walking on his toes. Subhanallah, he smelled good fragrance in his grave. سعد بن معاذ, just 6 years in Islam or 7 years. احنا we stay 8 years in Islam, 80 years and we did nothing. Subhanallah, see? But this is how the Sahaba, they approach Al-Jannah while they are still walking on this earth. We have to learn. Subhanallah, the black lady, imagine that, I'm talking about just Suhaib, يعني also الصحابة, سلمان الفارس also. The black lady, what the black lady? The black lady, that lady, she used to, كانت تقوم المسجد. Whenever, سبحان الله, dogs, they used to, there is, Rasulullah's masjid, it was, what they call it, the Rauda now? This is the original masjid of the Sahaba. Rauda, what is that? You pray to Raqqa, you fight to pray to Raqqa. This is the original masjid of the Sahaba. It was open, no doors. Just some branches of palm trees, the shade. And it was simple, easy. Kelab, dogs and cats, they used to pass by it. And they used to urinate and they used to stool in it. And that black lady, she used to come and she used to clean it. كانت تقوم المسجد. فرسول الله عليه وسلم was tired after, I think, the battle of Dhat-ar-Rifa. He was very tired, summer time. And subhanAllah, the lady, she died and the Sahaba, they buried her. After a while, Rasul sallam, he missed her. He said, what is that lady? They said, Ya Rasulullah, she died and we buried her. He said, why did not tell me? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I was tired. Yeah, we don't want to bother you. said, what is her grave? And he went to her grave and he prayed for her. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That lady, she will go to Jannah, Rasulullah said that. Not because of her salah or prayer or hajj. Or because she used to clean the masjid. She knows the value of the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a sign of iman. Subhanallah. A Bedouin man too. A Bedouin man, he came to Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, tell me something. If I do it, I will go to Jannah. I said, say la ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. Establish your salah. Make siyam and the zakah and the five pillars. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, I will not do any extra. He said, in sadaqa dakhal al-jannah. If he is honest, he will enter Jannah. That's khalas. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من سره أن ينظر إلى رجل من أهل الجنة فلينظر إلى هذا. If you'd like, if you'd love to look at somebody, you'll enter Jannah, look at this man. Because he's doing the faraid. Just be away from the haram, the whatever Allah forbids, and do the faraid. That's it. Your salah is very important. You know, subhanallah. Sayyidina Fatima رضي الله عنها, the daughter of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told her, or he told, she said, she told me that I was the mistress of all the women of the inhabitants of paradise. سيدة نساء أهل الجنة رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. يعني سبحان الله يا جماعة, الصحابة they lived, they give everything to في سبيل الله. They give their time, their life, their money, their kids, their children. Look at خديجة and أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه, عبد الرحمن بن عوف, عثمان بن عفان. The صحابة they give, they give. And that's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى said the upper hand is better than the lower hand. Upper hand for giving, supporting. That's why Islam said the Muslim must be strong. المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني when he mentioned that مسلمة, she came to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, she said, يا رسول الله, all men they go for jihad and what about us? What about us يا رسول الله? He said, if you serve your husband and your kids, حسن التبعل لزوجك المرأة, قال هذا this is the door of Jannah. And he said, فاستجاب لهم ربهم أني لا أضيع عمل عامل منكم من ذكر أنثى بعضكم من بعض, ذكر male and female. See, فالمرأة والرجل male and female they are equal in the reward in the punishment. Very important. طيب we have to سبحان الله, how can we earn the glad tidings of Jannah like الصحابة؟ طبعا يا جماعة, first of all, we has to establish the correct faith. صحيح العقيدة, the creed. Don't worship others beside Allah. Nowadays we see people, they call them Naqshbandi, whatever, Tigani, Baqini, Batikhi, Watikha, whatever they call them. احنا, we don't care about this. احنا follow the Quran, the correct sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Somebody think he's sheikh, he's gonna take him to Jannah. Nobody gonna take him to Jannah. Your sheikh is kharban. He needs somebody to take him to Jannah. These people, they've been misguided. يا جماعة, follow the Quran and the Sunnah. That says the correct faith means the correct عقيدة, correct creed. The main source for us to take our deen, the Quran and the authentic Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. تركت فيكم ما انت مسكتم به لن تضلوا بعدي أبدا, كتاب الله وسنتي عليه الصلاة والسلام. Also be steadfast in righteousness. أيوة, الاستقامة على الدين. You want to go to Jannah? Be steadfast. And we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى 17 times in سورة الفاتحة, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. بلس نوافل 29 times. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. يبقى correct your عقيدة. Steadfast in your with righteous good deeds means you have to guard your salawat. The pillars, five pillars is the main thing. And follow the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad and his companions. Yes. Because this is the shortest way to go to Jannah. To follow Rasulullah and his companions. Yes. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Very important يا جماعة. سبحان الله. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير. And this ayah for الصحابة and for us until the day of judgment. Indeed, those who believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they follow their belief with what? Righteous good deeds. For them, jannat, not garden, gardens with S. Underneath, rivers flow. ذلك الفوز الكبير. And that is the supreme attainment. Supreme winning. الفوز الكبير. There is nothing better than that if you go to Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Kahf again, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Indeed, for those who believe, Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbi, we believe in your oneness. And we follow that with righteous good deeds. عمل الخير, righteous good deeds has no limit. Can do too many things. كانت لهم جنات الفردوس. This is higher. جنات الفردوس, the highest level in Jannah waiting for you. خالدين فيها for eternity. لا يبغون عنها حولا. If you go to Jannah, would you special firdaus, would you like to leave? حولة means you're going to turn your face. Yeah, I don't need it. That's why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. All of my ummah will enter Jannah except those who refused. He said, يا رسول الله, who gonna refuse to enter Jannah? Stupid. Imagine that if somebody ate the gates of Jannah open for him. And the Malik said, we'll come, brother. Enter Jannah. He said, no, I don't want to go. He said, كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة except those who refused. They said, who gonna refuse your answer? يا رسول الله. He said, من أطاعني دخل الجنة. Whosoever obeys me will enter Jannah. ومن عصاني and whosoever disobeys me, the one he refused. أيوة. يبقى to follow رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the shortest way to go to Jannah. Also, learn الصحابة's سيرة. Seek inspirations from the companions of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Study their life. Try to say, والله I love عمر بن الخطاب so much. And if you ask any one of you, I'm sure you love certain صحابة. You are different. One brother was telling me, I love Khalid bin Walid. Brother Ahmed, where is he? He's not here today. I love Khalid bin Walid so much. Maybe he read something about him, he loves him. And for me, I love Umar. Umar is the best for me. صراحة. طبعا from the, Abu Bakr is the top. Abu Bakr better than Umar. Well, this is what we believe. But Umar, يا أخي, Umar, since he became Muslim, Islam became different. Since he died, Islam goes down. Yes, Umar ibn al-Khattab is different. Even Rasulullah said in Hadith, if a Nabi will be after me, there is no Nabi after Rasulullah, he will be Umar. كان محدث عمر بن الخطاب القرآن 5 times in the books of علوم القرآن comes by his opinion. عمر is different يا أخي, سبحان الله. أبو بكر is the top, طبعا he's better than عمر, of course his iman is better than all the iman of this ummah. رسول الله said in the hadith. Also some righteous deeds that qualify for glad tidings of paradise, believing in Allah and fearing him. If you believe in the oneness of Allah and you fear him, you go to Jannah. Allah, أو who said that? Allah, سورة يونس verse number 64. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Who's the ولي of Allah? If you ask any general people, said, the ولي of Allah, the one in the grave. أولياء الله. يا أخي, let's go make نذر for ولي الله. For the شيخ, for بطيخ. It's not, no, you are ولي الله. You? Yes, you are ولي الله. Allah said in the ayah. Do you know who's ولي الله? الإمام النووي said, the one who's doing the فرائض and the avoiding the حرام. You are ولي الله 100%. Who? Allah said. Look at the ayah. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ Those who are close to God, subhanAllah, shall certainly have no fear, nor shall they grieve for those who believe. For those who believe. Are you believing the oneness of Allah? And are mindful of God. There is good news in this life and in the hereafter. The word of God shall never change. That is the supreme triumph. طيب. This ayah in Surah Yunus, verse number 64. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, who's waliullah? Allah said, give the definition already. الذين آمنوا, those who believe in the oneness of Allah. وكانوا يتقون, and they have the fear of Allah. The fear of Allah means, when I mention it in my tafsir Nur al-Bayan, I said it. It is not only the fear of Allah. We say تقوى الله, it is not الذين يتقون, not only fear of Allah. To keep your duty to Allah. This is the meaning of taqwallah. It is not, yes, I fear of Allah. Allah is carrying gun and he's going to kill me. This is the meaning of fear too. No. When you keep your duty to Allah, this is the meaning of taqwallah. To keep your duty to Allah means what? To avoid the haram and to do the halal. Means to follow the manhaj, the revelation. Means al-Quran, do and don't. If you understand this, shortcut, that's it. You have the fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla. You keep your duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لهم البشرة. They get the glad tidings in, during their life. What is your bushra? The good dream. If you, somebody see good dream for you, or you see it yourself, this is bushra from Allah to you. لهم البشرة في الحياة الدنيا. This dunya, or before your time of death. The malaika will give you glad tidings of Jannah while you are dying in the process of death. وفي الآخرة. الآخرة also glad tidings for you. لا تبديل. Allah will never get to change his word. That's it. This is for you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also الصبر. If you are patient, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, I explained that ayat before, for any kind of calamities, when you will be struck by any calamities, and you say, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنِّي إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, this is also will take you to Jannah, inshallah. In general, be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will take you to Jannah. And Allah said, وَالَّذِينَ اجْتَنَبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوهَا وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى. If you avoid the taghut, what is taghut? Some scholars say taghut is the shaitan. And some scholars say taghut, anything from الطغيان, transgression. You worship others beside Allah and the transgression. طيب. He said those who are avoiding الطاغوت, they have good news. فبشر عباد الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسن. If you listen to that, whatever Allah saying and the Rasul saying, and you follow the best of it, you will go to Jannah. That's it. لهم البشرة في الحياة الدنيا. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said. That's why brothers, take away this. So take it. Take it. Don't think twice. سيدنا سعد بن أبو قاص said that when في عمل الخير, when you do something good, don't think for 2 seconds. Because if you think twice, الشيطان gonna come and gonna hate your mind until you don't do it for any reason. قال سوى لا أقعد ولا نام صراطك المستقيم. إن صراط مستقيم good deed, you're gonna find me. شيطان said to Allah that you're gonna find me there and you're gonna stop them. فده سوى إني عمل خير. For example, now I am thinking to go to the masjid for salah. If you said let me do this, let me do that, you think twice and something, you're gonna be busy somehow. الشيطان will see you will and you will not come anymore. خلاص. Even if you come, you become strong, maybe you come late. You're not reached تكبيرة الإحرام behind the imam. And this is different reward if you come behind the imam for تكبيرة الإحرام. I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى يا رب العالمين to, inshallah, to make us all, يا رب العالمين, to bring us all the way he brought us in the masjid for صلاة الفجر today. Inshallah, in جنة الفردوس الأعلى, the highest level of جنة يا رب العالمين. I'm asking Allah أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال. أم نسألك يا ربنا الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل, ونعوذ بك من النار ومن عذاب النار ومن كل عمل يقربنا إلى النار يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احشرنا في زمرة النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا, وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.